Okay, good afternoon students. Today we are going to see about some basics of control system. Okay, today topic is control system. Before that, we know about the system. What is meant by system? Actually, system is defined as number of elements or components connected in sequence for particular function. That is called a system. For example, take this pen. So this is a simple system. Why it is system? How would you tell the system? Actually, number of elements. This, what are the elements available in the system? Actually, these will be needed. These are everything as collection of elements. These elements connected. And then connected in specific manner for particular function, using for particular function. It is called a simple system. Okay? So, what is the system? Number of elements or components connected in sequence for particular function. That is called a system. Okay? Now look to the control system. For example, what is the simple system? Example of simple system. It takes a simple level process or flow temperature process. These are the examples. Okay? Okay, fine. Now we are moving to the control system. Okay? So when the output quantity is controlled by a varying input quantity, that is called a control system. For example, now take this pan, any pan, maybe a level pan, or flow. Then we are taking example for any one pan. So now we are giving to the input and we get the sum output. This is a simple system. Okay? Now, what is the control system? When the output quantity is controlled by a varying input quantity, that is called a control system. Okay? Now, we will give you a controller for the controlling purpose. And here, error detector, some plus minus, is an input, is a reference. The output is, the current output is sensed by a sensor. And this current output sensed by sensor, this output is given to the error detector. This is an error detector. Normally, the control system is an output quantity is controlled by a varying input quantity. This is our control system. So, the control system having components, first of all, we have reference input and then error detector, then controller, then plan. Plan will be a final controller. So, normally, the plan controlled by using finally which element to be controlled using a controller. So, normally, level controller having final element is control valve. The control valve controller. So, how will this process act? So, normally the output is, what is the output? The output is sensed by a sensor. The sensor output is given to the error detector. So, the error detector is comparing the reference value and current output value. So, compare this value and finally get an error signal. This error signal is given to the controller. Okay? The controller generates the control signal based on your error signal. This signal is given to the plant. Okay? So, plant may be a final control element. The final control element acts as acting by a controller. The controller action is given to the final control element. Finally, we get a desired response. Okay? This is the overall response of closed loop system. Okay? Normally, the system, control system having two types, open loop system and closed loop system. So it is a closed loop system. So taking open loop system having a model of harmonic system having will give an input and then output. Okay? This is a simple structure of open loop system. Okay? What is the drawback of open loop system? Actually, it supports any external disturbance occur in the system, what will happen? It will not automatically correct the error. So, the system affect definitely will be from the output side. So finally we will not get a desired response. Okay, this is the main drawback of the open system. So how will you eliminate this? Actually the open system automatically corrects the response, automatically corrects the error, handle the error. So finally we will disturb the final output. So this is the main drawback. Suppose the system will affect the any disturbance, external disturbance, what will happen? It will not automatically correct the output. So it is the main drawback. So this drawback overcome by a closed loop system. So what is the difference between open loop system and closed loop system is, so now this modify, this open loop system modify the closed loop system. How it is modified? So here adding a one controller and give a feedback. So the feedback is one part of this signal, that means output signal having the sample is given to the comparer, that means error detector. Okay, the error detector is compared the what is your set point, that means what is your required value. It may be a, for example, level process, it may be a 10 15 centimeter, you have maintained your requirement is 15 centimeter. Okay, this is your set point. Okay, now final output is 10 centimeter, means what will happen? The output is given to the error detector. The error detector detects the, that means compare the input value, that means reference value. Your set point is 15. So now current value is 10. So what will happen? Generate the error. So error is 5. The 5 is the error signal is given to the controller. The controller generates the control signal. Okay? Control signal. So control acts like the control. It may be a controller, different type of controller available. Proportional, integral, derivative control axis. So lots of controllers are available in control system. It may be a Thanos controller, PA, PD, PE. This is another simple example of controller. Control axis. Okay? Right. Now, what is the difference between open loop system and closed loop system? Actually, the system having inputs, that means reference, the input, reference signal or set point value. The set point value is given to the controller. What will happen to control is, generate the control signal. This control signal is given to the final control element. What is the final control element? You go into control, finally it will control the level. What is the final control element? For example, the level controller having the final control element of pneumatic control rod. Okay? The pneumatic control is controlled by a control signal. Finally, we get a desired response. So, it may be an, for example, temperature process. What is the final control element? Final control is temperature. That means heater. The heater is the final control element. So, the control the final element will get a desired response. It is the final control element. So, it is the input. It is, it don't have feedback signal. This is the main drawback. What is the drawback? How it is rectified? Actually, the drawback is, it suppose any external disturbances occur in the system, what will happen? System will be affected. So we learned it. That means the controller automatically predict the, cannot predict the error. So you cannot change the error, so we will not get the desired response. This is the main drawback of the open system. Okay, so this problem overcome by a closed loop system. Okay, this is the one closed loop system, or the general black diagram of the closed loop system. Actually, the closed loop system consists of, this is the reference input, the reference input given to the controller. This is the error detector. The error detector, what is the purpose of the error detector is, if the error detector is compared with your reference signal, that means set point value and current output value. You compare these two values and get a difference. That means difference between the this feedback signal and the current output. That means your reference signal. Reference signal and feedback signal. Compare the these two values and get the difference. So this signal is given to the controller. The controller generates the control signal based on the second control group, varying by using a control axis, and it will get a desired response. Okay? So this way we can control the closed loop system. So this is the overall idea of the control system. Yes? Okay.